Hello everybody, welcome back to High Functioning Gaming. I'm fully planning to finish up Code Vein, or rather get the, what was it, I think it's the Dwellers in Darkness ending, but, well, yesterday got a rather nasty, I got a pretty nasty surprise, and Kennedy, I could use a change of pace to help keep from losing it while I sort things out. So figured I'd start my Let's Play of Salt and Sanctuary. Might as well go with my screen name. Oh. Huh? Okay. Yeah, I guess I'll just stick with that. Effects? I wonder what that challenge thing is about. The world has known war for centuries, but peace is finally preciously near. We deliver the princess to the kingdom across the sea, where a marriage alliance would save us all. Failing this mission would surely plunge us into darker days.
You there, stranger. We've been bored into the night. They'll want to kidnap our lady. Ransom her.
Ooh. Guess he didn't get to finish that thought. Brutal. Oh. Probably ought to move that. Well, it was supposed to be a hopeless boss fight anyway. Failing this mission would surely plunge us into darker days. I woke to the sounds of waves washing on rock, and I knew I was alive. I must find the princess. Let's see. You're just a fleshy bit of flotsam washed ashore with the rest of us, hmm? You want shelter, you want sanctuary. But what is a sanctuary without faith? There's an empty sanctuary up the beach. You can claim it for your creed. Tell me, do you keep the new gods? You don't keep the new gods? Rare. So are you a pilgrim of Devrara? Your sort has been dying out for centuries, I'm afraid. Do you hold no gods at all? You're either brave, foolish, or from the north. You don't look particularly brave, but you don't seem particularly foolish either. Are you a mountain smith? Figured I'd go with that creed. Not that great in the long run, as I sort of heard, but it'll... it'll do in the meantime. It's not just the left on the D-pad. Or the right. Whatever. Gonna use some of those healing potions accidentally. Didn't know he had a follow up to that attack. Walkers. Was that what the zombies in Walking Dead were called? Or am I thinking of a different show? I don't know, I've never watched The Walking Dead. I'm not Cable. Stop being so reckless. I played a bit on a different character. I think I've gotten the hang of the game. Like I said, I think I've gotten the hang of it. Okay. That's one of the things I needed. So I guess that's just a save point, but not a sanctuary. Here's the other thing I needed. Really, I might actually, I'm probably going to struggle a bit with this game, because the main way I'm used to evading attacks in a Metroidvania is by, you know, jumping around and that kind of thing. Not by using a dodge roll or blocking. They really do mean some. Exactly, willpower does. Maybe that's the stamina. I'm also kind of used to the B button being used to exit out of menus like that. Hang on, how did I miss that door? Why won't it open? Huh. Wait. what they say, use it or lose it. Blocking attacks with shields reduce the damage of the attack to scratch damage in Dark Souls? I wouldn't know, I've never played it. Yeah, I knew there's another one that spawns around there. At least. Okay, so you can wind up attacks like that. Cage for the strong attacks, though. What the? But I blocked that! Get back here! Heck. Yeah, not surprised about that. Ow. Ah, crap. Missed. Ah, dagnabbit. And of course, the game turns me to the little checkpoint, but not the actual sanctuary. There. Yeah. Salt might be more valuable, but not past the gold. I want my salt back, dang it. Now, gimme! Dagnabbit. Like I said, I'm used to jumping over stuff to dodge. What did I do with the Sodomite's ashes? Is it crafting or something?
Greetings, traveler. Do you have a quest? Rescuing a princess, hmm? I haven't seen any princesses, but don't lose hope, friend. Anyway, it's good to have a quest. Would you like to know that what my quest is? Sure, why not? Excellent. My quest is to invade that castle to the east, defeat its guardians, and slay the dragon. Castles must be invaded and dragons must be slain, mustn't they? Yeah, I suppose so. Ow. Bolt, flame bolt, torch, stained page. Crap. Gotcha. I was gonna need more of those. Okay, that's what I figured that the poultice pass referred, poultice pouch referred to. Gotta be some way of warping between sanctuaries. I mean, most Metroidvania games do have some kind. Well, you're either able to warp between save points, or there'll be other stuff that you can warp between, like warp rooms that are specifically for that. Well, if I'm not mistaken, with Souls-like games, usually you're able to warp between the... Huh. I missed that. Usually able to warp between the save points, right? Yeah, I kind of knew that already. Must have been down that way anyway. Hello, traveler. You're a stranger to Devara's light, are you not? We are pilgrims of the goddess Devara, illuminator of all. Without light, there is nothing, it is said. In darkness, chaos dwells, and in chaos, there is no hope. Every night the sun sets and we see her light flicker in candles and torches. But the dawn of the next day is her blessing. Chaos is quelled, order is restored. Yeah, willpower determines maximum stamina. Okay. That's what I figured. Of course, strength increases my damage, and endurance is going to increase my maximum equipment load, and by extension, my mobility. Decisions.
with those weird obelisks? Are they just there, or is there some kind of significance to them? Seriously? Put up my guard. The second I put it down, they unload on me. I'm supposed to be the only one doing that. Alright. Seriously? Take that, you bastard. Yeah, that extra point of that extra point of willpower did me a whole lot of good there, didn't it? So how does that stack up to what I've got? Terribly. Too bad bows aren't very good in this game. The heck? I don't like the looks of this. Can I help you, sir?
Well, well, well. Looks like this is the end of the road for you, friend. If memory serves me right, the obelisk here is your door into the castle. The key, however, now that's a different story. Perhaps you should search the area below these seaside ruins where a forgotten feast festers. Yeah.
I've got to get some more fire pots. Of course, that means I'm going to have to check all the way back to the other sanctuary. Not quite sure why a potato would be a weapon or weaponized item. Yeah, whatever. Well, there's another obelisk just like the one in the castle, so what's the deal? And there's the buzzer. So as always, folks, do not stop being awesome, and I'll catch you in the next video. But until then, take care.